All right, let's forget about the phrase trusted sources for today, as we get to see the Galaxy Note 20 from the source. As yes, we have some, I guess we could say, official leaks of the Galaxy Note 20, and they're looking really good. The iPhone 12 lineup just keeps on getting more and more confusing the further we go, and the processor of the OnePlus Nord just got confirmed by another official source, I guess I would say. I'm Jaime Rivera, and I guess companies are thinking, never send a leaker to do a company's job. Or so they say. This is Pocket Now Daily, sponsored by MediaTek. Stick around to learn why you should pick MediaTek for your next purchase. The official news today begin with deals, and don't worry, not all of them are going to be about Apple today. We actually have some nice ones to start off the month of July. Let's begin with the Pixel 4, which we just revisited after the Android 11 public beta. Make sure you watch that video. But yes, it's $100 off, leaving the 64GB variant for $699 shipped. The Pixel 4 XL is $107 off, leaving it at $791 shipped for the same amount of storage. The latest MacBook Air is $100 off on Amazon as well, leaving it at $1,200 shipped for the 512GB variant. And you can also go over to B&H and you can find the 256GB variant for $899. And then we've got more deals on Motorola phones, USB docking stations, and others in the links in the description. Now, you've got to admit it, ever since the Poco F1, whenever it launched, that phone really made some headlines. Poco F2 Pro was, I guess, a continuation that was a little more expensive, but the company is not stopping there. We are going to see more. The company just took on Twitter to announce that they will be releasing a new device called the Poco M2 Pro with the hashtag #FeelTheSurge. The announcement and the launch will happen on July 7th at noon, and the phone will be an exclusive to India. It'll reportedly be a rebranded variant of the Redmi Note 9, as they have similar model numbers, and it'll be powered by the Qualcomm Snapdragon 7 series. We'll keep you posted on more information as it develops, but you gotta hand it to Poco. They've really been, I don't know, they've been killing it lately. Now, obviously, we're getting closer to the Samsung Galaxy Unpacked, and as we do, we get more information that is sort of official on the products that are coming. The Galaxy Z Flip 5G recently went through a TINA certification, which revealed some of the specifications we covered earlier, like the dual batteries that added up to 3204 milliamp hours and the 15 watt fast charging. On the certification, we can tell that the Z Flip 5G comes in a new gray color variant, which wasn't on the original Z Flip. We have some new leaks on Twitter that show the color variant, and apparently there's a new AG glass tech for a matte finish. Thankfully, this phone would fall off a table really quickly, and it was a horrible fingerprint magnet. Now, also moving on from that, let's discuss Samsung, as we know that IFA is still going to happen in a very unorthodox way, and the company just pretty much confirmed that they won't be attending. According to a South Korean publication, SEMI wants to avoid mass gatherings and complications due to the pandemic. And even if this isn't an official statement, it makes sense, which also gives us a hint on how the Samsung Galaxy Unpacked might or might not happen, or how it's gonna go on. All right, OnePlus, I am going to admit that you have my attention, particularly with the way that you're handling the Nord and this whole documentary series. And obviously we're waiting for the next episode, but it seems you won't have to wait for more official data. The company just tweeted out, "You asked and we delivered," on their UK account. And none other than Qualcomm quoted the tweet to say they're excited to work with OnePlus on their new beginnings, which will be powered by the Snapdragon 765G. So yes, stay tuned. We should be seeing more. We are expecting this to happen sometime in early July. And no, guys, don't look at me funny. I don't have the phone yet. Pinky promise. And yeah, price tag $350 or somewhere around there, that is going to be crazy. Now, a company that's not doing a good job, or nor have they ever, in leaking their products, because they never do, or sort of, or I'm not going to comment on that, but point being, iPhone 12. It's been all over the place. We've got so many analysts, so many leakers providing information that we don't know what to trust anymore. And this could just be that Apple is somehow controlling information out there in order for us to provide weird developments. So bear with me. Today we have Nikkei Asian Report saying that there might even be months of delays when it comes to the mass production, but Apple is doing everything they can to shorten the postponement. Apparently some of the iPhone assembly could be delayed until October, so it wouldn't be surprising if we got more delays down the road. Now, Ming-Chi Kuo also reported yesterday that the millimeter wave iPhones will be delayed due to some changes in the antenna package. But anyways, that's that. Now, on a separate note, a tipster on Twitter claims that the iPhone 12's box will be thinner and quite exquisite this year after, you know, they get rid of the charger and the AirPods. And finally, the DSSC's Ross Young just put out a new 120Hz device list for the rest of this year, and he says none of their contacts can confirm that the iPhone 12 will bring the 120Hz, so they're taking it off the list. But here's the thing, Ross, I know you have insider information, but it's not like if you know exactly every phone that's gonna get launched for the rest of the year, or do you? And if you do, then I don't know. I wouldn't consider this official, which is the reason why it's not the hottest news. And friends, before we get to today's question, in addition to the hottest news, here's a word from today's sponsor, MediaTek. Did you know that its technology powers the Amazon Echo Dot? This is Amazon's most popular smart speaker, which fits perfectly in small places and brings improved speaker quality. Ask Alexa to stream songs from Amazon Music, Spotify, Sirius XM, and others. You can also set alarms, control your smart home, and more. It includes MediaTek's far-field communication technology, so you can whisper to it from a distance. You can find a ton of deals on it in the first link in the description, and then you can also follow the second one to learn why brands like Amazon trust MediaTek. Thank you for sponsoring this video. And finally, the hottest news today have to do with the Samsung Galaxy Note 20 lineup. We've got case renders, we've got leaked renders, we've got videos, we've got so many ways to tell you so much about this phone, but we were waiting for something official because it wouldn't be the first time that Samsung somehow ends up leaking their phone. And well, today is the day. Samsung Russia accidentally uploaded a picture of the Note 20 to their website, showing off the new camera array, the new S Pen, and that leaked copper color variant, which is apparently going to be called Mystic Bronze, which I find hot. This time we see a triple camera array that still includes the periscopic lens, but it's just not apart from the others like we saw on the S20 Ultra. The 100x text is now gone, along with the time of flight sensor, which will be replaced by laser autofocus. Now, we weren't able to see the display, but we are still expecting it to bring the center punch hole with the smaller bezels. But in today's question, let us know, what do you think? Do you like the renders? Do you like the color? Do you like the design? I can't ask you if you're gonna like the camera hump because I don't know anybody that likes camera humps, but let us know what you think about this design in the comments. And second, what do you think about these kinds of leaks? Because honestly, I'm like, you know, when I see these and they accidentally uploaded a photo or posted it, I'm like, all right, we're kind of far from the event still. So I don't know how accidental that was, but I don't know. That's just me. Leave us a comment down below. We'd love to know your opinion. Friends, again, if you want to get the news earlier, follow us on PocketNow.com and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. Also, follow us on social media so our extended coverage happens on Instagram, and follow me on my personal handles to see me discover official leaks, if you could call them that way. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I'm Jaime Rivera. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you tomorrow.